Hello and welcome back to an academy. So let's get clean. PG, myself Dr. Muskan Chaudhary, and we will today study about the Pseudomonas. So starting with an academy is India's largest learning platform where we get access to both the live and the recorded sessions, learning from the India's topmost educator for any medical examination, be it NEET, UG or the PG. Competing the TNDs and test of preparation with a highly competitive quizzes, study on the device of our choice and benefit from the exclusive chance of watching the lessons on the bigger screen with access up to 25,000 of the MCQs with printed and the digital notes that are being provided. Under Icon subscriptions, the prep letter has come together with an academy, and you get access to both the clinical and the integrated essentials with video lectures and the Q banks with rapid revision snapshots and the 2022 dream notes with the well-structured live batches, recorded sessions, Q banks of around 25,000 MCQs, competitive TNDs, and the digital notes with the printed one. So under Plus, for 2 years, it will account around 1,500 per month, that is 36,000 for 2 years, and for 36 months, it is 1,250 per month, and for 18 months, it will be 1,625 per month. For Iconic, it is around 58,500 for 2 years, that is 2,438 per month, and 2,875 for 18 months, and 1,875 for 36 months. Do use my code, that is MUSKAN10, to get 10% of the discount on the subscriptions. Raise a hand feature, that is something new, and you can get personalized, make your classes sessions personalized with highly interactive sessions with your educator by raising your hand and one-on-one interaction that will enable the interactive and the fast doubt-solving sessions with 25,000 of high-yielding MCQs based on latest examination patterns and detailed explanations. Special class features includes the live sessions. You can do the polling for the learners and respond to the polls for a better understanding of the topic. Raise a hand because you to clear your doubts and to get the notification for the same, because you will get notification for any class that is going to be happen on the Unacademy, and to get the lecture notes and study from anytime and anywhere. Boost your medical preparation because for 24 months you will get 4 months totally free, 12 months you get 2 months totally free, and with 6 months you get 1 month totally free. And do use code, that is MUSKAN10, to get 10% of the discount. So now we'll start with the Pseudomonas. Starting with the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Now it is what? It is a gram negative bacteria and with mono trichus flagella, that is single flagella, monotrichus flagella, non-capsulated and do produce the slime. If you remember, we studied in the slime that it is irregularly arranged glycocalyx around the bacteria, and that was streptococcus and the staphylococcus as well as the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So that was producing the slime and it is called as algid, and causing the disease, that is the cystic fibrosis, where we call this line as the algid. Now one important point to remember, that it is strictly an arrow. Here, what else we have? The strict arrow, we have the mycobacteria, that is also a strictly arrow organism. We have the Pseudomonas, that is strictly an arrow. Now, talking about the biochemical reactions. Talking about the biochemical reactions, that we need to remember that it is catalase positive and oxidase positive. It's important that they are both catalase and the negative catalase and the oxidase positive, as well as nitrate reduction test positive, but they doesn't ferment the sugar. All right, on the culture media, they are what? They are non-lactose fermenters, and they show the highly mucoid colonies, beta hemolytic colonies on the blood agar. Okay, so remember they are catalase positive and the oxidase positive with nitrate reduction test, that is also positive. Now, when we talk about the culture media, that is a cetrimide blood agar. That is a selective media for the pseudomonas, and the colony shows the characteristically sweet fruity grape-like smell. So on the cetrimide blood agar, we get the sweet, fruity, grape-like smell on the cetrimide blood agar. Very important point that it produces the pigment. It produces the pigment. Number one is what? Pyocyanin. That will give what? Blue green color, and another is the pyoveritin, that is the yellow pigment. Next we have the pyomelanin and pyorubin, that is the red pigment. Alright, so on the cetrimide blood agar, the colony shows the sweet, fruity, grapes-like smell, and it produces the pigments pyocyanin, pyoveridin, pyomelanin, and pyorubin. Rubin is the red pigment, and the pyocyanin, remember the person is having like cyanide and turns the blue. So, blue-colored pigment. Then we have the pyoveridin, that is a yellow. From the melanin, that is the black-colored pigment, and the rubin, that is the red-colored pigment. Now, talking about the virulence factor, they have the LPS. Since it is a gram negative bacteria, so they will have the outer membrane. Outer membrane will have what? Lipopolysaccharide. Then this, they also have the adhesin protein. They have the slime. That is also an important virulence factor. Other than this, they have the exotoxin. That resembles the diphtheria toxin. And it causes the inhibition of the elongation factor 2, that is inhibiting the protein synthesis. Remember the mnemonic for the protein synthesis, that is the don't synthesize protein. D stands for what? Diphtheria toxin. S stands for Shiga toxin, as well as EHEC toxin, that is enterohemorrhagic E. coli toxin, and responsible for causing the HUS, and it is due to the Shiga-like toxin, that is a virocytotoxin, and P4 pseudomonas. So don't synthesize protein, they all actually inhibit the protein synthesis. Alright, so this is how the mechanism of action of these toxins, that is inhibiting the protein synthesis. Apart from this, they do have the exoenzymes. Not so greater role in that of the virus, but they have the exoenzymes, and then they also have the hemolysin activity. Apart from this, they also show a phenomena that is what? Theorem sensing, that is when the col that is a colony has increased for the Pseudomonas, then there is a cell-to-cell communication via the autoinducers after reaching a particular density of the bacteria. So that is a theorem sensing, that is they sense each other, and after a particular concentration of the organism has reached, there is a cell-to-cell communication via the autoinducers. So this was important virus factor like lipopolysaccharide and the adhesins, protein and the slime and the exotoxin, exoenzymes, hemolysin, curium sensing, and how they act, they actually inhibit the synthesis of the protein. Now, when we talk about the disease, one we have is the community acquired one. Now, it is the most common cause of the corneal ulcer in the contact lens users. Alright, the Pseudomonas is the most common cause of the corneal ulcer in the contact lens users, and they are also responsible for causing the otitis media mainly in the swimmers, causing what? Also known as what? Swimmer's drive disease. They also cause the enteric fever-like illness, that is known as the hot tube folliculitis or the Shanghai fever. Important one, that is the common cause for the corneal ulcer in the contact lens user and the external otitis media in the swimmers, and causing the Shanghai fever and the hot tube folliculitis, that is also known as the hot tube folliculitis, also known as the Zakuzy disease. And also can cause the infantile diarrhea. The important names we need to remember, that one is the hot tube folliculitis or the Zakuzy disease, and they cause the Shanghai fever and the swimmer's drive disease, that is the otitis media, and the common cause of the corneal ulcer in that of the use of the contact lens. Next, we have the nosocomial infections. Now, the most common is the burn infection. The commonest cause for the burn infection is the Pseudomonas, and mainly the immunodeficient people who are admitted into the ICU. And they are the main susceptible people for the nosocomial infections. Other than this, can cause the wound and the bed sore infections because it is an opportunistic one. Post tracheostomy and ventilator associated pneumonia. Causing the cystic fibrosis, and UTI in the patient after post catheterization. So nosocomial infections, when we talk about, most commonest is the burn infections, wound infection, bed sores infections, post tracheostomy, and the ventilator associated pneumonia, cystic fibrosis, and the UTI after the post catheterization. Pseudomonas do have the multi drug resistance, and it is mainly due to what? Plasmid mediated. Coming to the treatment of the Pseudomonas, that is, can be remembered by the mnemonic, that is a campfire, that is C4 carbapenem, A4 aminoglycosides, M4 monobactam, P4 polymyxin, F4 fluoroquinolones, I4 third generation cephalosporin, and E4 extended penicillin. So that is a campfire, that is carbapenem, aminoglycosides, monobactam, polymyxin, fluoroquinolones, third generation cephalosporin, and the extended penicillin. This is the treatment for that of the Pseudomonas, including that is the third and fourth generation cephalosporin. Now we'll see some important images. Now this is the stromboid fish. Now what happens in the stromboid fish is that when the stromboid fish, they are actually not refrigerated properly, or they are what? Not kept, when they are not kept at proper temperature and not kept refrigerated properly, then they got spoiled. And after eating the spoiled fish, that is a scomboid fish, meaning includes the mahi mahi and the blue fish and the tuna, what happens? They contains a chemical that is histidine. And since in this fish the bacteria is multiplying, and due to that the bacteria multiplication, they turn the histidine into the toxin, that is the scrombotoxin. Okay, and the main component of which is what? Histamine, which is responsible for the symptoms of the food poisoning by the, that is the scromboid fish poisoning. It is caused by eating the spoiled fish that has not been refrigerated properly, and mainly the toxin is what? Heat stable toxin, that is the histidine, and the toxin breaks down to that of the histamine or the scrombotoxin, and the patient will present with the skin flushing and the headache, with the abdominal cramps, nausea, diarrhea, and palpitations. And these symptoms start appearing just within 10 to 30 minutes of eating the fish. Just within 10 to 30 minutes of eating the fish, the symptoms will start appearing. And mainly the bacteria that we are dealing, that is Pseudomonas, is one of the important causative agent for the scromboid fish poisoning, converting the histidine into the histamine and resulting into the clinical symptoms of the fish poisoning. So this is the biochemical test that we talked about, is the Pseudomonas is both catalase as well as the oxidase positive. Catalyst positive means that is the breakage of H2O2 into H2 and O2, and we will see the bubbles. That is a catalase test positive because of the catalase enzyme. Now, appearance of the purple color, that is the positive oxidase test, and very important test, that is the oxidase test for the pseudomonas. Now, this is the cetrimide blood agar, and on the cetrimide blood agar, pseudomonas, they have the characteristic sweet, fruity, grape-like smell. Alright, on the cetrimide blood agar, they have the sweet, fruity, grape-like smell. These are the pigments that are formed by the pseudomonas. Then pigments, that is the pyoviridin, that is the red pigment. Then pyorubin, that is the red pigment. Then we have the pyoviridin, that is the yellow pigment. And what else we have? The pyocyanin, that is the blue green pigment. Okay, now this is, we are talking about the pigments of the pseudomonas, that is the pyoscyanin, pyoviridin, pyorubin and the pyomelanin, and these are what the diffusible pigments into the media. This is the otitis externa, that is in the swimmers and also known as the swimmers drive disease, and mainly in the people who are what professionally swimmers, also known as the swimmers ear. That is caused by the excessive moisture having the bacteria pseudomonas and leading to the maceration and the inflammation. Main, that is the most common agent, that is the pseudomonas, apart from the staph and the streptococcus and occasionally fungus. Now this is what, this is actually the hot tube folliculitis or the jacuzzi disease. That is, patient will have what, generalized folliculitis. Now this is the pseudomonas in a single picture, that is the gram negative, and mainly is the most common cause for the burn infection. That is the most common cause, and people with immunocompromised people, that is the opportunistic infection and nosocomial infection were causing the post-catheterization UTI, ventilator-associated pneumonia, cystic fibrosis, and the slime that is produced here is known as what, Elgate. Now that is, these are the virulence factor for that of the pseudomonas. What are the virulence factors we read about? One is the addison, that is the pili, and what else they have? They have the exotoxin and the endotoxin. Exotoxin is responsible for causing what? For the inhibition of the protein synthesis, similar to that of the diphtheria toxin. These are the pigments that are the pyoscyanin and the pyoviridin, and having a thick, because they produce the slime and they produce what, the biofilm, and it is an important virulence factor. Now these is what the symptoms, that is having the malignant otitis externa, that is the swimmer's ear and the nosocomial infections with the pneumonia, ventilator associated pneumonia, hot tube folliculitis or the jacuzzi's folliculitis, erythema gangrenosum, and what is Very important, burn wound infection and mainly in the immunodeficient person with the green exudate. Now we'll move to the next fermenter. Now we'll move to the next fermenter. The right now we discussed about the Pseudomonas. Now we'll deal with water, maleodorsis. But before maleodorsis, we'll see the Burkholderia malai that is responsible for causing water glanders disease. That is mainly in the horses. It is an animal disease that is mainly seen in the horses. So that is the Burkholderia malai, and it is a non-motile bacteria. So Burkholderia malai, that is responsible. Please remember the name of the disease. That is what? Glanders disease, and mainly an animal horse disease. Next, we have the maleodorsis, that is by the Burkholderia pseudomallei. Both the pseudomallei and the malai, they have the safety pin appearance, and we'll see the list of the bacteria having the safety pin appearance. Burkholderia malaria, that is causing what? Maleodorsis, and that is also known as Whitmore's disease or the Vietnam bomb. So that is the Burkholderia malai and the pseudomallei, and they are having what? The bipolar staining. That is what they show, the bipolar staining or the safety pin like appearance. And the maleodorsis is caused by the pseudomallei and also known as the Whitmore disease or the Vietnam bomb. So it's a gram-negative bacteria with the typical safety pin appearance or the bipolar disease, bipolar staining. So this you can see the safety pin appearance and the bipolar staining. Safety pin appearance of the bipolar staining, remember, it is seen in the Yersinia, important one, as well as the Vibrio parahemolyticus. Also, the Vibrio parahemolyticus shows the swarming type of motility. It is not only by the protease, even the Vibrio parahemolyticus also shows the swarming type of motility. Next, we have Burkholderia malai and the Pseudomallei, Klebsiella H. Haemophilus ducreyi, Campylobacter. They all have the safety pin appearance. Yersinia one is important one, so is the Burkholderia malai and the Pseudomallei, Vibrio parahemolyticus. So this was a short session about the Pseudomonas. We quickly revised in the 5 minutes what we did covered, and we'll do the next. We'll do the cover up the MCQs. So we talked about the Pseudomonas, and we talked about that it is a gram-negative, it is a monotrichus, and it is non-capsulated but having the slime and the biofilm, and it is a non-protein, it is a protein inhibitor. We remember by the mnemonic, don't synthesize protein, the diphtheria and S4-Schigar toxin and P4 Pseudomonas. It is catalase and the oxidase positive test, and important test to remember, set on the cetrimide blood agar, it showed what? It showed the this sweet fruity grape-like smell, and apart from the pigment production by the 100% of the strains, and the pyoscyanin, pyorubin, pyoviridin, and the pyomelanin. Pyoscyanin, that is the blue, pyorubin are for red, pyoviridin, and that is the yellow, and the melanin, that is the black. Then we talked about the virulence factors, that is the slime and the biofilm and the exotoxin, endotoxin, and the exotoxin A, that is having got the elongation factor 2 inhibitor. And the quorum sensing, that is when the concentration of the Pseudomonas increases, then there is what? ऑटो इंड्यूसर, दैट इज द क्यूरम सेंसिम, दैट इज सेल टू सेल कम्युनिकेशन इज देयर. डिजीज वी रिमेंबर्ड इन द कम्युनिटी, दे कॉज द एक्सटर्नल ओटाइटिस मीडिया इन द स्विमर्स एंड दे कॉज द हॉट ट्यूब फॉलिकुलाइटिस और द कूजीज डिजीज एंड दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉजिंग द कम्युनिटी, दैट इज द शंघाई फीवर. एंड इन द नोसोकॉमियल दे कॉज द वोंड इन्फेक्शन मेनली इन द इम्यूनो कॉम्प्रोमाइज पीपल एंड द वेंटिलेटर एसोसिएटेड निमोनिया, पोस्ट कैथेटराइजेशन यूटीआई एंड द सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस. Now, Stromberg fish poisoning is due to the conversion of the histidine to that of the histamine, mainly in the on those Stromberg fish group, that is a tuna and mehi mehi blue fish and all. What happens when the bacteria, when the fish is not refrigerated properly at a right temperature, the bacteria multiplies and convert the histidine to histamine, which is a scombrotoxin and responsible for causing the oral burning, nausea, palpitations and the food poisoning, and which appears just within 10 to 30 minutes of eating the fish. Pseudomonas, that is oxidase positive and produces a purple color just within 1 to 2 minutes and shows the bubbling, that is a catalase test positive, shows the bubble appearance due to the release of the oxygen. On the citromite blood agar, we had the sweet fruit grape like smells. And these are the pigments. Remember, they are diffusible pigments into the media that we need to remember: the pyocyanin, pyorubin, pyoviridin, and the pyomelanin. Swimmers here, or the Otitis externa, the most common agent is Pseudomonas, apart from the staph and the streptococcus. This is the generalized folliculitis or the hot tube folliculitis or the Jacuzzi's folliculitis that is seen in case of what? Pseudomonas. We have covered this, that is the most commonest cause for the burn infection. And these are all the balance factors that we covered: endotoxin, exotoxin, pili, and the multiple drug resistance, that is what? Plasmid. The thick biofilm, slime, and the pigments. And on that of the burn infection, patient will have the green exudate and hot tube folliculitis and the swimmer's ear, nosocomial infection, and the ventilator associated pneumonia. The treatment we remembered by the mnemonic, that is what? That is a campfire. That is what? The campfire, that is the carbapenem, aminoglycosides, monobactam, as well as polymyxin and the F4-fluoroquinolones, third and the fourth generation cephalosporin and extended penicillin. Mycobacterium malai and Pseudomallei both have the bipolar staining or the safety pin appearance, and the malai is responsible for causing the glanders disease and Pseudomallei is Whitmore's disease or the melioidosis. The safety pin appearance and the list of the safety pin appearance bacteria is the Yersinia, Pseudomallei and the Malai, Vibrio parahemolyticus and the Klebsiella H. tuberculi and the Campylobacter. So this was it. It was a half an hour session. Half an hour session. Thank you for the session and please do use my code, that is MUSKAN10, to get 10% off the discount. I will see you at 9:50. We'll cover the MCQs of the Pseudomonas that we are left with. We'll take that in another session just after 10 minutes. So take care and do press the bell icon. We are now just taking the short session so that it is easy for the aspirants to actually learn within the short sessions, because long sessions becomes boring. So that is was a Pseudomonas we covered in 30 minutes, and we'll cover up the question answers in at 9:50 p.m. just after 10 minutes. So, and please do attend the NEET PG combat examination to be held on 28th of November at 5 p.m. and get up to 100% of the scholarship and up to 20,000 of the Amazon vouchers, and use my code, that is MUSKAN10, to enroll into the NEET PG combat and do attend the session. And on the basis of your All India rank, you will get the scholarship. So don't miss that. It is a great catch deal for the aspirants. So take care and bye bye.